The Economics Prize this year, which formally is called the Sveriges Riksbanks Prize in Economic Sciences in memory of Alfred Nobel, has been awarded to two scientists that has thought a lot about auctions and auction designs. Their names are Paul Milgram and Robert Wilson. This prize is very important because auctions is everywhere, and they affect our lives directly and indirectly almost every day. Whenever you pay an electricity bill, the price of electricity is determined by an auction. Whenever you open your web browser, the types of advertisements that you will see is decided by auctions that is run on real time. Every millisecond there are auctions on big internet auction sites. And when the European Union decided to have a common program for emission control back in 2005, the auction mechanism was key in determining the price of these emission allowances for CO2 emissions. So this is of great benefit for humankind, because thanks to auctions, we can now allocate resources more efficiently than we could do before. So why is it so complicated with auctions? In many auctions, the bidders don't know the true value of what they placed bids on. So let me give you a very simple example. Suppose that I would take this glass jar and I would fill it with coins. All of us can see that there is a value in this jar because it's full of coins, but very few of us can understand the exact value. And the same thing is true for if you have auctions for, say, natural resources like timber, oil, natural gas, and even the spectrum that we use to call with our cell phones. It is very difficult to estimate the value of that. So for example, in 1990, who could have guessed that all of us would have cell phones in our pockets today? So the value of the radio spectrum back in 1990 was very difficult to estimate. So because bidders don't really know the true value of the auction, they need to estimate it somehow. And different bidders have different estimates. And what has been observed is that the most optimistic bidder, they normally overbid, they overestimate the value, so they overpay for the object. So in the example with the glass jar full of money, the most optimistic bidder will overestimate how many coins that is in the jar. And therefore they will place a bid which is too high, so they overpay. So the winner of the auction actually turns out to be a loser. This is something known as the winner's curse. And both Robert Wilson and Paul Milgram has spent much time in thinking about how these situations can be avoided, in theory, but also in practical auction design.